thing.
He does. He's funny. He's got a bit more of a character now. Yeah, he's got a lot of humour.
Oh, I
was going to
swing.
Mind him going the leash, look.
Yeah.
He's good, isn't he?
Quick! I can't survive.
Let me turn Luke around and let me put it on him.
Luke's
look at me, big fat.
Hey.
Make sure everyone gets a bit of something, even if it's not very much of it. So they're telling each other where everything is. As you can see, it's a lovely hot day here at Chocolate Wings, so this one's a little bit tired. Have a bit of a rest in the sun. If it does get too hot out here, what they will do is...
Come, darling.
Lexi,
wait
for them to
close and then go up.
No, you can't have
Let,
darling.
He went like that.
Where's Let? I just paid one. Do you want to feed one?
No.
Yeah, please.
See ya.
Yeah,
I'll get one. No, I'm getting lying down, look.
Why
aren't
you going to
scream? I want to. Well, yeah.
Colin, can you go and get some lunch?
You can't go in there. They stand out.
Oh, look. What's that sack?
Did you see the little baby head?
Oh,
they usually white little girls.
It's been making
the baby head.
Yeah.
Can I buy it? There's others.
This is Esme. She's just over 2 years old. She is a Eurasian eagle owl, the largest species of owl in the world. And we're going to get her to do some flying with us today. Now, believe it or not, she may be big, but I've worked with bigger Eurasian eagle owls. Believe it or not, she's tiny. I've worked with Eurasian eagle owls. They're up to three times as large, three times as mean, and three times as powerful. I must say, she has very, very safe. Now, does anybody in the audience know what a Eurasian eagle owl might like to eat? Anybody, can I have a show of hands? What do you think she's a crisp or a snack to a Eurasian? What does anybody else think? Some of the boys and girls in the audience might know what a Eurasian might like to eat. Snakes. Oh, no, I've never heard of a Eurasian trying to eat a snake, but I'd be spaghetti, wouldn't it? try and get the gobble out. What do you think she might like? Rabbits. That's more likely. She'd definitely probably go out and catch a rabbit. That's the idea. We do give her terrible indigestion, so we try to kick that out of the diet. That was beautiful. You may also notice when Esme flies, she flies pretty much really low to the floor. Does anybody know why this might be? What do you think she might be doing this? Oh, what do you think?
New birds?
Okay. Well, it's because of the fact that, imagine her prey is going to be on the floor. So literally, she can fly up, snatch it up off the floor. She's also using another sense while she's doing this. Her hearing. Owls have a spectacular sense of hearing. Look at that lovely facial disc. She'll pick up sound in that facial disc and follow that bridge on her ears. One ear is actually higher than the other, creating a delayed response. She'll literally be scanning the floor for her food, and she'll catch it. Now, a lot of people like to use pretty much all our third handlers. Owls are funny, they pass it up to their beak before flying off with it. Now we're going to give Esme a few more flights. She is starting to slow down a little bit. This is because of the fact that owls do not have a crop, unlike other birds of prey, like our hawks or our falcons. They use to store their food in and then they'll just go and fly back to their roost. To then digest the rest of their food. The elves don't have this. So the food falls straight to her stomach. She'll get very full very quickly. As you can imagine. We know when the owl is paying no attention to us, flies off in the opposite direction. We know this is probably fed her too much. And we're actually getting her back on the glove. When it's made back on the glove, give her a nice round of applause. She did very, very well there. And Jason, backwards and forwards. He's doing his own marathon today. So as you can see, a nice outfit. Now, you may also notice that she's got these little tufty bits of tail. Flying completely silent and deep during the night. A little bit like ghosts. There's an eerie aura there. And another name, but I'm pretty sure, quite sure, not sure why, they've got the nickname the Churchyard Owl as well. Well, not the Churchyard, I already said that, didn't I? Myself. The monkey-faced owl. I see mine has had a little bit too much time in the limelight. Getting a little bit more dish. There's a beaver going on there. Too busy posing for the paparazzi in the audience. No, and she's just making Luke look very silly. maybe look. No, as I said, owls are very, very lazy animals. In the wild, if they don't have to fly, they won't. And she's obviously testing Luke here a little bit. It's all about energy if you're an owl, or a bird of prey, in fact. If they need the energy to hunt, they'll sit there. As long as they can, they'll conserve energy. She'll go off and I'm not having any of that today. Anyway, we'll point out a couple of minor features while she comes up to the front. You notice she's got lovely dark eyes there. You can use the colour of an owl's eyes to determine what time of the day the owl comes out at. Now she's got dark eyes, suggests an owl that is nocturnal, comes out during the night. It's diurnal, just like human beings, it comes out during the day. Born owls kind of break the rule, because they've been known to come out at dawn, dusk as well as during the night. And even possibly during the day. It's gone quiet, the suspense. Okay, suspense. I've had you all on edge here. The man knows what he's doing. He does. That's a response. There. Oh, there's a pigeon. Oh, okay. That's not part of the demo team. These are very, very clever pigeons, by the way. I love to sit up and watch. And then we have a hawk comes past and it looks. And I think one day that hawk's going to look at you and he's going to go, you know. No, Mina just doesn't want to go back to bed, does she? No? Okay, we'll give that Mina's round of applause. She didn't want to perform for that whole thing, then we put her away. She's like, no, wait. So it is a Harris hawk. These are typical South American birds. You can find them in places such as Central Argentina, Chile, Mexico, and then just into southwestern United States. Here we also like to call them the wolves of the sky. Now, get nice quiet there. Because of the fact they hunt in packs of up to 8 hawks. Now, all the ladies in the audience will be pleased to know that if you are a harris hawk and you're a female, you're in charge. Right at the top of the pack, they call the shots. They have to look after the nest and protect the young. They also get the right to eat first, perch high. Now the male, harris hawk, gets too confident for his own good. The female will pin him down and she'll pluck every feather from the top of his head. Shame on his boss. I do apologise to any board members of the audience. I meant no offence. It's just this world does not work like this in the human world. There'd be a lot of dead bald guys in the nightclubs. Now, hunting in packs actually has its advantages. First is protection. Can you imagine there are actually a few things that might... Oh, Scub's got a nice bite there. Get the audience going. You'll see his next trick, yeah, it's more spectacular.
I do, I never forget
protection.
It.
You get things like coyotes, we'll try and eat them. Also, whoa, that was really low to the ground. Also, it means they can hunt bigger prey items, such as jackrabbits or cocktail rabbits. Now, they hunt in a similar way to a pride of lionesses. One group of harris hawks will wait up at one end, up in the trees. Another group of harris hawks will wait up in the other end. Then one harris hawk will flush the prey item out. And what they'll do is they'll slowly close in on this prey item and triangulate around the rabbit. Then, usually the female likes to do the honours and makes the kill. Whoops! It's active camouflage there, yeah, she's trying to get in. I can't see. It's ready for tea. Oops! Okay. A bit of groundwork there as well. You can look at his legs as you can see. His feathers, there's no real feathers around his legs. He comes quite high up there.
He's spent
a lot of time on the ground, especially around the food. Also, you can imagine the kind of environment, it's like deserts they're going to be in. So that gives a little bit of shock protection there. We also believe they use their tail feathers, you can see him there. Repositioning himself, they like to wiggle their tail feathers to balance. We actually believe they use that white band with his tail feathers. It's very spectacular. Oh, look, he flew back to his perch afterwards. But on a real show for us there.
Watch him. Where is he now?
During the old days, they used to use hawks, falcons, as a means of catching food.
He's up
there. Though after the invention of firearms, it soon became a sport. Henry VIII, in fact, was a very, very famous falconer. He liked to hunt with falcons. You can imagine, it became known as the sport of kings. Imagine, your king with his horse back, his falcon.
Oh look!
Oh, like Jason Jones, having a chat there, down there.
He's going to come in.
Don't forget, nice flight down there, from the top T-post. And then we'll...
It's going to come there, look. Here
he comes. Did you enjoy seeing Hunter? Yeah, he even did a catch for all of you.
See you then.
Good. One more? Yep. Tucker? Yep. So I'm actually being a little bit carried away. We're going to get our next bird.
Yep, we're done.
Okay. Sorry. So we'll get our little framed out this box here. The arena. I'm sure Hulk is not there. Okay, so. Does anybody know what this bird might be? Has anybody seen this bird before? Yeah? Okay. He is a kookaburra. As we like to call them, the laughing kookaburra, and the Aussies, the Australians like to call them the laughing jackass. They literally laugh. This is a bird you'd find in Australia. This is a kind of bird with a short wingspan like this. You're going to find these sort of things wooded areas. But he's got rightfully short wings, but he can actually manoeuvre through the trees. Now, he's got a little bit of taste. He'll eat a lot of different things. They'll actually eat things like mice, maybe giant lizard or two, small birds, and also eat different insects as well. That little beak of his makes a very, very nice gardening tool. It's quite a nice instrument if you actually try and bite you with as well, as we all found out. He looks very cute, but I wouldn't want to go with him. I'll just wait for Tatum to finish his mouthful. Now the females are actually just a little bit bigger than the males.
They're massive. I like that big one standing there. That's massive, isn't it?
Hello, Grandad.
They're quite big ones, aren't they? Compared to ones we saw.
You get bigger than me.
I'll put it away.
Dad, don't, because they're going to jump over.
But it was so good.
Oh! That's why it's so sweet.
The thing was come over.
Oh no, look, that's why, look.
No, I ain't got no more, yeah.
That's why
I'm not doing it.
Oh, go for anything.
Oh, he's going away.
Did you get it?
Break the rules, stepped over the rope.
Can you see Daddy in the background? Look, big eye. Come on.
Why did you just step over the rope?
Here's Daddy, look.
They're from the
guinea pigs
and the
chinchilla
family.
Hello, Daddy, in the
background. Yeah, drive
quick, bubs. What? I'm just running out.
Oliver, stop it, please.
Look. Dad, look, Sonia.